building places to work, to learn, to shop, to play, to retire, makes for sustainable community living. Roger Heifer is a nationally known town planner and regeneration expert.
Here we are at the village of North Stainley. Charming village on the edge of the Yorkshire Dales, surrounded by lush Yorkshire countryside. It's a village of about 290 homes with some charming features. Village green, village hall, village pub. A really pleasant place. However, there is a problem, and the problem is that it's essentially a dormitory village. People live here, but they don't work here, and they aren't able to shop here. And this is typical of problems being faced by many communities in modern-day rural Britain. Villagers don't have enough facilities to sustain themselves.
The Stainley family has been rooted in the village for centuries. James Stainley is behind the plan to create a new future based on sustainability.
Our aim is to try and turn North Stainley into the most sustainable rural community in the UK, or at least one of them. This is a blueprint. There are not many other villages in the country that have come from what was effectively a very small ribbon development with a higgledy-piggledy sort of collection of houses to a fully sustainable, fully integrated community. A place that people are proud to live, enjoy living, and ultimately want to continue living for the most of their life.
We just thought, what a beautiful, beautiful village. And everybody just seems so happy here.
It's a lovely village. It's really picturesque. We have lots of things going on as a community. We love it here.
We just had a feeling that this is the place where we could make the big move from Cheshire to Yorkshire for the next part of our lives.
We're now next to the main proposed housing site. Really good site for housing development. It's well defined by the woodland in the background. It's close to the centre of the village. It's a very developable site. And the proposal is that this is developed with mixed tenure housing, including affordable housing. And then down here we have, on the site of this former petrol station, the location of a proposed shop, a combined local convenience store and farm shop specialising in locally sourced products. And again, the location of this is fantastic, sort of right in the heart of the village, very accessible on foot from both the existing housing and the new housing. A really sustainable form of planning.
Sustainability is about being able to almost be born in the village, go to school in the village, grow up in the village, perhaps get your first job in and around the village, develop your career in the village, and dare I say, retire in the village. So it's looking at the complete life cycle of a resident and making sure there's no leakage from that life cycle.
It would be lovely not to have to get into the car to get, like, say, a pint of milk, a newspaper, a pint of beer. Mm. It would be lovely to be able to just walk. And we do walk a lot in the village, with the dog. But it would be lovely to have facilities where you can just nip, see your neighbour there, have a coffee, that kind of thing.
Yeah, there's no shop, there's no real facilities. The village hall's fantastic. The school's bursting at the seams. There's nowhere really for us to do a youth club or anything like that. So the small people in the village are missing out a bit.
Ripon's only 4 miles down the road, and the Dales, so that, you know, there's everything in other places, but it would be nice if there were some things that were here. You've got to get in the car to go and even to get a newspaper or some bacon, you've got to get to West Hanfield.
Here we have an area which historically has been occupied by large agricultural buildings. Most of them have now been cleared, and we have a very uneven series of hard standings. It's a classic brownfield site, and it's really quite well screened from the surrounding area. It's a great opportunity to develop a mixed scheme with new business accommodation, which could be the sort of accommodation that's required by start-up businesses and the sorts of businesses that thrive in rural areas.
We've suffered from a number of problems, and those problems include the pub closing 5 times in 10 years, We also have the problem, obviously, with the school and the fact that its future is uncertain.
A primary school is really very much at the heart of any sustainable community. And here at North Stainley, there is a very successful existing primary school. The trouble is, the building that it's in is very much in need of a lot of investment. It's not ideally located. The school has to use playing fields on the other side of the main road. They're short of space. They have to use the village hall. So there's a very strong case for having a new school provided. And as part of the plans for the development, the expansion of the village, a new school is proposed. This is the site of the proposed retirement community. On the edge of the village, but positioned so as to be very much integrated. And this is really important for two reasons. One is because the village needs mix and balance. It needs to cater for all types of people. And with an increasingly elderly population, appropriate good provision for older people is really important. Secondly, this will generate value, which will then help to pay for all the other elements of the project. Without it, it won't be possible to deliver all the other sustainable features of the village, which are very much part of the vision. What's planned here is really very interesting. It's recognizing that here we have a village that has an awful lot going for it, but which needs change in order to make it more sustainable in the future. It needs more people living here. It needs more wealth bringing into the village to sustain the school, a shop, a pub, all of those things which make a village a village. And what's planned here is a series of relatively small interventions which add up to a really suitable whole. And it's worth reflecting on the fact that whilst this is very applicable to this village, it's also applicable to a great many locations throughout the UK. This really is a pioneering model that could be transferred to many, many other places.